How many people in here like college sports or even seen a college game? Okay, so here for the ladies, how many have ever had a crush on an athlete? Okay, and I'm pretty sure you guys have done that too. No, not guys, alright. Just keep it simple. Okay, one of the reasons college athletes really go to go to college is to have an education, right? But for the most part, a lot of people think that, well, we just come here with the easy way, we get a scholarship and so. So I will be talking about the reasons that, or the things that we struggle with and certain things like that. One of the main reasons is that obviously we come here to get a college degree. A lot of people are not fortunate enough to have scholarships and stuff like that, so we have to find a way to come to college. And what's our option is going and playing sports. A lot of you guys are gifted with knowledge, and you're very good at school, engaging with students and stuff, and we are too. But most of the time, the problem is that we have so much things in our plate. It could be home problems, anything related to that. And one of our kind of escapes would be college sports or sports in general. I just think it's a great way to go to college and look for something to strive for, to get lawyer degrees, doctorate degrees, and all that good stuff. So the NCAA organization, right? This is the National Collegiate Athletic Association. This organization is one of the main organizations that take care of college sports. So when you watch a bowl game, a March Madness and all that, basically they make money off of the college students or the college athletes. And throughout the season, like around 2011, 2012, they made $705 billion in revenue on college athletes. So what that basically means is once you turn on your television, you're seeing the game, basically they're making money off of that as they go along. And really, how much athletes do they get to see, like, that portion of the money, right? Another thing is that people think that, oh, I mean, we're athletes automatically. There's gajillions of scholarships, so you can come and play. Well, that's not the case here. I mean, there's roughly around 11.7 scholarships that each program is allowed to have in the team. So you think about 11.7 is 11 players. In baseball, there's over 1,600 colleges in the nation. And out of those, there's roughly about 50,000 college baseball students. So think about breaking down each scholarship in 1,600 colleges and divide that off of the 50,000 baseball players there is in this country. So think about it. If there's a team that has 25 to 30 students, like here, like South Mountain, that's roughly what we have here. Not everybody is very privileged to have a scholarship. For example, myself, I know Jacob too. We're what we're called the walk-ons. Basically, we come to pay to come play school. And I'm not ashamed to say this, but I'm not very fortunate to have the money to pay the whole school. So basically, what I do is have student loans. So I've been coming to school with student loans and stuff like that. So eventually, after college, I'm gonna have college debt. Going back to saying how the NCAA makes money, basically it's the whole bowl games. When you purchase a ticket, they're making money, profit out of that. You buy any shirt, any college shirt, any type of thing that goes into the NCAA. Really, even the colleges don't even have the luxury to see most of that money, and especially us, the students, we don't have to see it either. It makes sense that once you watch a college game, really, how many people think, hey, are they getting paid? Or how you're just basically saying, oh, well, they have it easy. But in all reality, there's a backside to it where you struggle, you still need to eat. You still need a good place to be sleeping under. I mean, it's not a whole deal. Basically, it's a full-time job for us. We go to school, train, and then at some point we gotta do our homework, all that good stuff. So it's a struggle sometimes, but it's gonna pay off eventually in our college future. One of the things I think we should do is sign a petition to make college athletes get paid, to get like the bare minimum, so that way we have ways to pay maybe a little bit of the college debt, get food, groceries, stuff like that. Because then they think about $705 billion makes a big difference if you just like distribute it to the athletes and just have a living off of that. And then, well, other than that, how many in here think that athletes should get paid after knowing that you have $705 billion just for the organization itself, and they really just keep it in their pocket, and us athletes, we just struggle out here, basically try to make a living and try to get our life together to make a good future. Thank you.